Welcome to Positive Atheism English channel. Today I am present you the book on Thoughts of Periyar compiled by Dr. K. Veeramani. Why should we dare to deny God? They say I am an atheist. I assert I am an atheist in the sense they denote the word atheist. One who is afraid of being dubbed as an atheist cannot achieve anything. Moreover, only an atheist can propagate principles of socialism. Atheism is socialism. That is why they said the Soviet regime in Russia is atheistic. They said Buddha was an atheist because he sought to propagate egalitarian principles, change and equality. Atheism is not only socialism but also reformation. Those who support orthodoxy and tradition will dub any attempt to change outmoded ways and principles as atheistic. Where there is no respect for reason and no room for equality, there springs up atheism. Jesus and Muhammad. Even Jesus Christ was called an atheist by the Jews and Prophet Muhammad by the people. It was because they spread egalitarianism and worked for reformation. Now, we want to bring about certain changes. Those who oppose change assert that the prevailing order is established according to the will of God or His incarnations or His messengers and prophets. So, reforming or destroying the prevailing orders amounts to violating God's command. For example, the scriptures say that God had created the four broad caste divisions or varnas. It has become necessary for those who want to eradicate caste to deny God. The same is the case with people in other religions. When the attempts to reform or to remove inequality are opposed on the ground that the prevailing order is divinely ordained, the reformers and egalitarians refuse to respect or pay attention to God or to divinities. Christians call non-Christians heathen, Muslims call non-Muslims kafirs, and Hindus dub the non-Hindus as milachas. A few examples: if ups and downs are divinely ordained, the act of leveling them is one against God's will. If hair growing in face and on head is divinely ordained, then hair cutting and shaving are acts opposed to God's wish. To a certain extent, these activities are atheistic in nature. We find hair grown on in spite of repeating shaving. Yet we continue to remove it again and again. This is nothing but distilled atheism. Where there is no respect for reason and no room for equality, from there springs up atheism. A man is hungry and has no food. It is said that God has punished him for his karma, his evil deed in the previous birth. If it is so, giving him food is an act against God's wish. It shows lack of faith in God or giving no respect to his wish. If we think on these lines, we will find no atheist in this world. As far as we are concerned, we want several changes to take place. This amounts to atheism. No one can bring about even a little real reform without being an atheist, without questioning scriptures, and without acting against religious teachings. Not God, but folly is the cause. People of our own country cheat and exploit the poor here. They defraud the common people who believe everything happens according to God's wish. We have to awaken those common people and make them realize that action of God are not the cause of their poverty and penury, but their own folly in the cause. Only when they are taught not to bother about the actions of God, the common people will come to know of the atrocities of the wealthy. At present, building a temple is said to be acting according to religious injunction. But in future, demolishing temples and breaking the idols to build educational institutions and factories may be considered meritorious religious deeds. In the same way, several things now considered to be dharma may be considered adharma in future, denoting a total change in outlook. Such being the case, if all things prevailing now are said to be God's injunctions, those who want to change the status should dare to deny God's commands, not God himself. Only those who deny God can annihilate the atrocities now committed in the name of God. Contrarily, those who are afraid of God and aspire for heaven can definitely do no good. Thank you.
For more videos, please subscribe to this channel, Positive Atheism, and activate the bell icon.